Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are new. I am Whitney and I am a fashion reseller on apps such as Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, and Depop, and also a soon-to-be organizer in the business realm of organizing. If you would like to see any of my organizing videos, I upload those every Wednesday. It's called When It Works Wednesdays because that's the name of my business. And every Saturday, I upload a reselling video like you are watching now. Okay, so today's video is a little bit different than, my mom. She's probably gonna FaceTime me. Okay, I think we're good. Oh, no, there we go. There we go. Hey, mom. Hello? Oh, call failed. So, I just had a long intermission there after my mom called. So if the lighting has changed, it's because it's nighttime. It's like almost 8 o'clock at this point. But yeah, we're just gonna get right back into it because I got ready. So we finishing this, or even starting it. We didn't even start, so we're starting this. Okay, so basically this video is gonna be about me reacting to / answering questions from the Facebook groups I follow that I'm in that has to do with reselling. So these are gonna be from Poshmark, Mercari, Depop, eBay. I think those are the only ones. There's some Facebook Market one stuff, but I don't really do Facebook Marketplace. So those are like the main four platforms, which are the ones that I sell on anyway, that we'll be talking about today, I guess, or we'll be pulling from today. I already pre-chosen some questions to answer or posts to read to react to / answer the questions. So this will be a series on my channel that I want to do kind of as like a series, something that happens often. Maybe every other week or so, since I'm only posting one video a week that has to do with reselling, or maybe I'll add some extra videos during the week. Who knows how it will go. But this is just something that I wanted to do because I thought it would be kind of fun, something different than we see on a lot of Poshmark YouTube pages now. And I kind of just wanted to be a little bit out the box. And because I don't have nobody who follows me or who subscribed, really, I got about 50 subscribers now. I feel like this is a good way to have like a Q&A type of thing without having a Q&A. So we're gonna get right into it. Once again got the trap phone. Oh, we gotta have the trap phone on deck. And we're just gonna go through these, and I just hope y'all enjoy. Hopefully y'all learn something, might laugh a little bit, whatever. So I do want to put the actual comment up on the side. Hopefully my editor will let me do it, because they done changed stuff. Or maybe I'll just, you know what, I'm gonna just add that in as I'm talking. I don't think I'm gonna be able to put it in no more unless I pay, and I'm not trying to pay nobody right now. So I'm not gonna say which groups is from. Obviously I'm not gonna say no names, anonymous, blase, blase, blase. So this person said, oh, I lost it. Oh no. Oh gosh, Whitney, hold on, okay. She said, so what do you do about the annoying waiting for payment on eBay? It's been 6 days now with one buyer. I've sent them two reminders. Why is this even a thing? I don't understand. How long until you cancel and relist? Girl, I feel your pain. Oh my gosh. I feel your pain. Me and Chris recently had like 8 items that was just unpaid for in our eBay store. And they take about a good week for them to cancel and relist. To be honest, I'm not that great at knowing like all the eBay stuff. So I do wait until it tells me I can cancel and relist. I feel like you're able to do it sooner, like after 3 or 4 days or something like that. But I just wait because I don't need no issues with eBay. We've already had a ton of issues with eBay before. So we don't need no new eBay issues, especially because now that eBay is working for us, we don't want to mess up a good thing. But I feel your pain on this one. Honestly, my only response to this is just wait until the item says that you can cancel and relist. Like, it'll literally say that under the item, under the sold, if they haven't paid for it. I do think eBay needs to change this. This is unfair to the buyers, honestly, because the item is just sitting there waiting for it to get paid for. And most buyers, I can't say most, but a giant portion of them don't even buy the item. And that whole week, you could have put your item back on sale, but instead, it got to be waiting for this person to potentially buy it or not buy it. And you can't make money off of it. It's like, I hate it. eBay has so many things about it that I just can't stand it. I feel like they need to change. Like, certain things need to be updated. They're doing all these updates and all of these things, and this needs to be one of them. It needs to be immediate payment. There shouldn't be an option for immediate payment. It should just be immediate payment. Next one. Okay, so a buyer purchased 3 items individually from my closet, so 3 shipping fees. I immediately messaged her and let her know we could cancel and combine shipping. She looks new. If I don't hear back, should I cancel? The items she purchased, I have multiples of, and I mean multiples. I thought I could add an extra in each package, which would more than make up for shipping help. So she did say edit, she replied, and nope, she actually meant to buy them separately, so problem solved. But I'll be addressing the first part. First things first, yes, you want to have good customer service. Anytime somebody buys something from me that is like the same person will buy multiple things, and sometimes it depends. If it's like something expensive, occasionally I'd be too nervous to try and cancel it and have them repay, and I'll just let it fly. But for the most part, I'll message the buyer and let them know, hey, I'm not sure if you know, but you can actually, you know, combine your items and get shipping on just one instead of paying multiple shipping prices for each item. And most of the time, people agree to it, I cancel, and they actually repurchase. I rarely have any issues. I don't think I've ever had an issue, honestly, which I'm grateful for, because I know a lot of people are scared about that. But what I want to specifically address about this is, okay, so you messaged her and she didn't respond. Should you cancel? No. Why would you cancel it? Like, you're taking money out of your own pocket for that. Whether the buyer knew that she could bundle the items or not is not your problem. She saw how much it was going to cost at the end of the day. So just go ahead and ship the items out after. Shoot, for me, I give it like 1 good full 24 hours, maybe 2 days. And after that, I'm just like, it's going. I honestly don't care, because the last thing I need is for them to say, never mind, I want to cancel it because you haven't shipped yet. So if you're ever in this type of situation, don't consider canceling it, and don't wait forever in a day to actually ship it. Just ship it out and just move on with your day and whatever you have to do. I mean, there's no consequence from that. She knew what she was paying for. All she can say is, oh, thank you for letting me know. I didn't know. I'll know for next time. Like, that's it. Next thing. I have a problem that is becoming increasingly serious. I sold a jacket to a buyer. As I was getting it ready to ship, I noticed I made a mistake on the listing regarding the size. The listing said a large, but one of the pictures I submitted shows the label and size to be a size 8. The description said a size 8. I also had approximate measurements in the listing. I immediately sent the buyer an email. I never heard from her. I have since then sent 3 emails to her and have sent 3 emails to Posh asking them what I should do. In the meantime, I got an email from Posh reminding me to send the jacket. I have perfect feedback until this. I really don't know what to do until I hear from the buyer. Any suggestions? Yes, I have a suggestion. Ship the item. It's kind of the same thing as the last person. Just ship it. This is why I personally love Poshmark, is because there's very little to no risk, as long as if you're, you know, honest, you're doing the right thing, whatever. But there's little to no risk on Poshmark when it comes to selling stuff. If you get less than a perfect rating, like I said in the previous video I did, who cares? Nobody. It's not like eBay where you see all your feedback, and a negative feedback really hurts your account on eBay. Like, it's all averages and whatnot. Like, your perfect feedback, oh, now it'll probably still be five stars. If you've always had 5 stars and you get one star out of nowhere, out of like 1,000 sales, you're still gonna have 5 stars. So it's really not gonna make that sense. So it's no need to stress about it. I've also done this before recently. Actually, I had the size in the picture as one size, but the listing, I listed it different, and sometimes people don't pay attention. I did message the buyer. It took them a few days to respond, but they did say they didn't notice and to cancel it. I canceled it, whatever. I was annoyed with myself, but I canceled it and was like not bothered by it. But if the buyer never answers you, then just ship the item. The worst that they can do is open a case and return it, and that's it. Just resell it. Next one. Quite often I see rude posts regarding lowball offers. I just wanted to share how simple it can be to acknowledge the offer without compromising your integrity as a seller. Have a great weekend. So she put a screenshot of the post. This is from Mercari. It says, single mom here, just trying to save money. Can I buy this for $10, please? And it looks like an Urban Decay palette for $19. The lady said, good morning and happy Friday. I don't have too much wiggle room left on this item to break even after fees. I could do for $17 if you would like. If not, no worries. I can ship today. And then she put her name. So to this, I say congratulations to whoever put that post out. Oftentimes we see a whole bunch of negativity when it comes to a lot when it comes on Mercari, man. Oh my gosh. But on a lot of posts, when somebody offers you a lowball offer, inside you might want to respond in a negative way, but at the end of the day, you never know how the sale can turn out. So it's always good to just be polite. That's basically what she did, is how I would handle the situation and say, you know, no, I can't. And it depends on how they do it too. Sometimes I just be like, no, that's too low, and just keep it blunt but never rude. But she did it perfectly. I won't have any wiggle room at that price. Like, I can give it to you for this price though. Like, she gave an option, and she was very nice in her reply to the customer. My only thing with this, and I always have this reaction when I see messages like this. Yes, you might be a single mom, you might be struggling, I get it, all of that, but this is not what you should be buying if you are struggling. Like, I don't need to hear the sob stories sometimes, because it's like, especially ones like this, if you can't buy it at a reasonable price, I'm not saying you have to buy it at full price, but if you are trying to sob me into giving you like dirt cheap and saying that you don't have the money for it, then you should not have no money for it at all. You should be using that money towards important stuff, not a Urban Decay makeup palette. And if you need makeup, then go to the drugstore and get something for $5-$10 for the purpose that you need it for. That's just my thoughts about it, but you know, to each his own, whatever. Next one. I see a lot of people worried about selling to new buyers. Correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't we all new at point with, oh, she ain't, okay, she ain't put at some point. weren't we all new at some point with zero ratings? A sell is a sell to me. If a problem arises, I will cross that bridge when I get to it, girl. Oh, guy, dude, shoot. I'm with you on that one. I don't understand why people always feel the need to check their buyers' profiles and stuff like that when they get offers or when somebody purchased from them and stuff. I could care less. I see that you bought it and I'm shipping it out. Like, I don't need to check your profile. I don't need to see if you knew. You sent me an offer, I'm accepting the offer. If we have a problem, then, like, as he said, we cross that bridge when it comes. But most of the time, there's no problem. So, what's the issue? Next one. Okay. Need some serious advice. Sold, I don't understand, but whatever. No, I guess some people just don't know. Need some serious advice. Sold a console Wii U and got this message. Hello, I'm interested in this. Is the box still sealed? And from the same person, this is the buyer saying this, and the buyer is saying this again. Apologies in advance if you already knew this, but please don't ship it directly. I would really appreciate it if you could ship it in another box with padding all around to prevent damage. Thank you. And then they said, the box looked like it is in good condition, and I would like to receive it in the same shape. So the seller is basically asking what they should do in this situation. It's a $300 console. I'm not sure if they had it as free shipping or if the buyer had to pay for shipping, whatever the case may be. But I definitely agree with the buyer in this stance for a couple of reasons. One, just being a sneaker seller, as somebody who wants to receive an item in the condition that it is posted online, especially when it comes to shoes, you always double box it. It's like a sin to send sneakers in the box that they, like, in the sneaker box taped around or just with brown paper over it. Because if you damage that box, it, that's not what I want to say. Whatever, I'll use the normal term. It really decreases the value of the item. Like, a full box in the sneaker world, if you're talking about, like, Jordans or, like, popular sneakers, a full box and a full box in good condition is worth money. If something is wrong with the box or if there's no top to the box, then you could be paying, like, somebody, you could be getting $100 less for that shoe than it would resell for if it had the full box. Like, it's serious. In this case, I kind of feel the same way for another reason as well. Also, like, this could be a gift for somebody, and nobody wants to give a gift that has been dinged up and banged up by the post office and is looking dingy, like you just got it off the side of the road. Like, no, or you have to pull the tape off that is wrapped around it. Like, some people be wrapping stuff crazy, but sometimes you want, or everybody wants, the item in the condition that they see it online. The other thing with it is, as well, as somebody who might have their packages dropped off in front of the house and it's not a mailbox or something, you don't want nobody knowing that you got a Wii right there just sitting at the front of your door for somebody to go ahead and grab. Like, so I honestly get where this buyer is coming from, and I don't understand why the seller needs advice. I mean, some people, you just don't know if you don't know, so I get it. You ask, and that's a good thing to do, is ask. But if they need it shipped in another box, ship it in another box so that it actually gets received to them in the condition that it should be. Like, nothing, they can't say nothing is wrong with it because you boxed it up properly and you put a little bubble wrap, which adds barely any weight. Yeah, you might have to add a couple dollars extra on the weight of the item, but it's not, in the grand scheme of things, it's not that big of a deal. So, like, just do what the guy is asking you to. You're about to get $300 out your house and in your pocket, and I think this is like a no-brainer. Let me see. Okay, I messaged Mercari to see how I can request for a return label to be sent to her. She has a screenshot of the conversation, which is why it has no context. She sent me this message, then rated me. I haven't rated her, so this transaction is not complete. Has anyone had this problem? I'm new to this. So the buyer said, hi, I don't know if you know this, but it was missing a gem or two on the dress. I still love it, but just thought I'd let you know. So she got a dress, I'm guessing something with some sparkly stuff on it, but had a gem or two missing, whatever. But she still loves the dress. She had said nothing about returning it, nothing like that. The buyer says, oh, you can process a return. I didn't see it when I inspected it. Sorry. I will leave it unrated by seller so you can process it. So she's basically not going to... The seller already rated her. Yep. The buyer already rated her. So on their end, the transaction is done. The seller is leaving her part of the rating open so that the buyer can potentially return the item. She then said, I messaged Mercari on how to process a return label. Never had this problem before. Ask them for help. Your funds has not been processed to me, and I haven't rated you or completed the transaction. So basically what I said, I get it. Some people are just new to certain things, but it's almost just like the buyer said nothing to you about wanting to return. She just made a comment saying, I love the dress, but it had a couple things missing. Just wanted to let you know. And with a smiley face on it at that. And then proceeded to rate her after that message. And the buyer, in her mind, saw that as she wants to return the item. So let me wait to get my money so she could return the item. She can't even return it no more. She already rated you. But even if she could return it, why are you giving, like, just take your money and go. Like, it's just like you're giving, I get it, good customer service and all of that, but you can't have good customer service if you don't got a business no more. Like, if you're not making any money, there's going to be no customer service because there's no more business. Like, I just don't understand. That makes no sense to me. I don't know how to help you, but just to say, rate her back and get your money. Like, she probably put you, it's possible you got a lower rating because you can't see the rating until you rate. Plus, you got a lower rating. So what? You got a lower rating if that's the case. And if not, awesome. You avoided a return. Nobody wants a return. Take the win. She just, it's not that serious, people. Not that serious. Okay, I think I'm gonna do one more. Let me see. Next one. What did you need to do to get your fee refunded after giving a refund? So this is a Depop one. Depop is just an interesting app to sell on. I've given Depop a lot of my money for free, basically. So with Depop, when somebody buys something from you, so I've had a couple people who brought something from me and either they made the mistake in buying it or whatever the case may have been, and they, you know, pretty much immediately asked if they could be refunded. So I had been doing that for however long, maybe at least 5 or 6 sales that I had on Depop that I had to like refund the buyer for whatever type of situation. And up until whatever that 8th one was or whatever that last thing was, I had no idea that Depop didn't refund you back the fee they charge for the item you sold. And I don't remember what, I don't know, I guess I was just paying attention to this day and realized that I never got my Depop fee money back because I returned the item to the person. Like, it didn't even leave my house. And it was a doozy trying to figure out how to get the money back. So to answer this question lightly, because there's like a whole bunch of stuff you got to go in. One, I would just highly suggest researching it. Two, you have to actually, there's like, gosh, it was so much. I had to research it, and I had to go to like a very specific place within Depop and then get like an email address from Depop and then send them an email address with like the item number, a picture of the item, and like all of this stuff to get my refund back. I feel like that's absolutely crazy. Like, I decided that day that I was going to do it for all the past things that I had refunded and never got a refund back from, but ended up just not doing it. I wonder if I still could. It's been like years for some of them things, but I wonder if I still could. But it was like so much that you had to go in to doing it that it was almost like not worth the effort of me getting my Depop feedback. So as a fair warning, if you are going to be starting Depop, definitely make sure you are, you know, aware that they don't automatically give you back the Depop fee. So you lose out on money by refunding a person, and you have to go through this whole process. I think I'll try and research it and then put it in a clip after this, because it is kind of an annoying process. But at least that'll be more helpful than what I'm saying to you right now. But as much as I love Depop, I also hate it in certain ways too. Granted, I don't sell that much on Depop, but when I do, it's probably 75 to 80% of the time an outright purchase, like no offer or nothing. And it's always on high ticket items, like $100 and over. So for that reason, I'll always have Depop in... deal with only having 1 to 2 sales a month. I don't care. It's not my main platform, but I love that about it. Okay, guys. So this is not a link, but like showing how you get your Depop fee refunded. It shows you have to fill out a contact form to get the fee refunded. And then it says you have to email the address link to your Depop account. You have to have your Depop name, you have to have the buyer's Depop name, and you have to attach proof of full refund to the buyer, like a screenshot from your PayPal. So it was a process. It's not something that's like all the way shown. Like, it's not something well known on Depop, which is the most annoying part of it. But you can find this like page on the Depop app. Or just Google, how can I get my Depop fund refunded, and this will come up. So, hope that helps. But yeah, guys, that's the end of the video. It ended up being a little bit longer than I wanted it. This was supposed to be a shorter video. If it ends up shorter, that means I cut some parts out of it in order to make it more short and sweet and concise. But either way, I hope you enjoyed it. There will be more. And yeah, I think that's it. I do think for future reference though, I'll probably keep it to one platform per video. So do just like all Poshmark reaction and questions, all Mercari reaction and questions, all Depop reaction questions. You know, you get the point. But I think I might do that moving forward, just so it'll be a little bit more concise for like if you're looking for something specific based off a platform that you actually use. But either way, this was fun. Hopefully I find some funnier, juicier, and more helpful questions to answer for you guys. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.